I'd like to welcome you to my resource page, where I share some of my favorite tools and resources for helping you deepen your connection to nature and expand your knowledge of ecology. I designed this video here for students that are in that Reading Nature's Forgotten Language course. And if you're not in that course already, you might want to check it out. www.naturesforgottenlanguage.com, where we help students deepen their connection to the land and learn to read and interpret all the tracks, sights, and sounds of the natural world. It's a really amazing course. We've been having a lot of fun with it. So the resources that I'd really like to focus on today, the first one is actually more of a concept, and I learned it from the Wilderness Awareness School out in Duval, Washington, when I got started in my naturalist training journey close to 20 years ago. And it's the concept of setting your place up to be really inspirational and setting yourself up for success so you're constantly learning. So what that looks at my place, number one, I've got my nice comfy couch over here. You'll notice it even has a deer blanket on it, and it's right beside my stack of field guides. So after a long day of work, I might be exhausted and come home and, you know, I sit down and I may be tempted to just throw on the TV or watch a movie, but I might also be thinking in my head, oh, I saw that cool book at, or sorry, that cool bird at work earlier today. Oh, wow, the field guide's right there. I can just grab it, pick it up, take a quick look and look who that is, making sure that I'm always learning. The other thing that's really amazing about this space and the way that I've set it up is I put things all over my family room that remind me about why I love nature and why it's important to me to keep growing and keep learning. So for example, right beside here, I've got a collection of some of my favorite feathers that I've found. You know, on any given day, I could pull one of these out and grab the feathers field guide over here and look them up. I've got an antler over here, all kinds of stuff that just keep me inspired and remembering why this is so important to me. The next thing I want to chat about is field guides. And we've got a whole bunch of recommended field guides down below. These are all Amazon links. So if you purchase a field guide through one of the links below, we super appreciate it because we get a little bit of a kickback from that. If you're in Nature's Forgotten Language course, I highly, highly recommend you either go to the library or you purchase yourself a great tracking resource. And I'm going to share my three favorite tracking field guides right now. Now there's two options depending on how much you want to spend. The first one, this is hands down my favorite field guide by a long shot. It's Mark Elbrock's Field Guide to Mammal Tracks and Signs, a guide to North American species. And this field guide, it's got so much information in it. And specifically, you know, a lot of field guides will have pictures of animal tracks, but they'll only show them maybe in the snow or maybe in the mud, or maybe it'll even just be a sketch. And what you'll learn pretty quickly is that what they look like in the field guide is often not what they look like on the ground. In Mark's field guide here, he actually has pictures of the animal footprints in all kinds of different substrates. You'll have pictures in snow, in sand, in mud, in leaf debris. So you'll get to see what they might look like in different substrates. It's also got a million pictures of what we call sign tracks. So pictures of animal scat, and it'll even show their scat when they're eating different diets at different times of the year. It's got pictures of chew marks that they make and feeding marks. It has pictures on kill sites and how to analyze a kill site if you come across, say, a deer that's been taken down by coyotes or wolves. It's got information on how to interpret the patterns that they leave on the ground. There's no other field guide that's even close in being as comprehensive as this one. So it's really worth the extra dollars if you can afford it. With that said, the other one, Peterson's Field Guide to Animal Tracks, is also a great field guide, not as expensive, still a ton of great information, and will definitely cover you for those course. So those are my top two. I really recommend you getting one of those. If you want to get a couple, you may want to consider getting this one as well. And this one's Tracking in the Art of Seeing, How to Read Animal Tracks and Sign by Paul Resendez. This one actually has some really cool stories in it about basically how do we look at and interpret tracks. And it's one of my favorite guides from the interpretation kind of perspective. It's also got some really good pictures and some really neat information you won't find in the other ones. This is a real nice adjacent one. So I like the idea of having like one of these two books, Animal Tracks by Peterson's or Mammal Track and Sign by Mark Elbrock, as well as Paul Resendez's book. That's a serious tool set if you get the two of those together. The other thing you might want to consider for this course is getting yourself a book on mammal behavior. So as you're out in the field and you start to develop deeper relationships with these wildlife and you see really interesting things, you hear interesting sounds, you can come back and do a little bit of research about the mammal behavior, especially if you want to photograph these animals or get develop your tracking skill to the point that you can actually observe them in the wild. Reading about their behavior is very, very valuable. So there's two great books for that. Again, Peterson's has a field guide to mammals, which is really, really useful. But Peterson's also has a larger field guide to mammal wildlife behavior. And I really, really recommend that one. Both links are down below. The last thing I want to chat about, in this course, we really talk about expanding our awareness of the natural world. And I've got a few resources that I really like for that. Having a bird guide is always really helpful for that because birds are huge in developing our awareness. I like the Petersons or the Sibley Guide for Birds. And this one right here, What the Robin Knows from John Young. Now, this is a book that teaches us how to actually interpret what the birds are saying. So not just, oh, I hear that call and it's a robin, but it's a robin and the robin is giving me this piece of information. Absolutely brilliant. If you want to expand your natural awareness and really deepen your connection, highly, highly recommend checking out this book. And then let's finish it off with inspiration, because it's really nice to just have a storybook once in a while that you can sit down and read that just inspires the heck out of you to want to go out and keep learning and keep growing. So my two favorite books for inspiration are two favorite authors. Again, Paul Resendez, the same guy that writes Tracking the Art of Seeing, has a book called The Wild Within. And The Wild Within is full of stories about how tracking and studying and spending time with wildlife completely transformed his life. And he tells all these beautiful stories from out in the woods, but also talks about how that actually influenced him as a person in the world. Really, really inspirational book. Another great author is this guy, Jim Corbett. He has a book called Maneaters of Command. This one's called Temple Tigers. And if you want to think about like pushing the far reaches and potential of human awareness and connection, this book is so inspirational on that realm. So I hope you find those resources helpful. Scroll down below, check out some of the links there. We've got them listed by topic. If you've got any questions, feel free to reach out to me at chris@naturesforgottenlanguage.com. And if you're not in the course, you might want to go check it out, www.naturesforgottenlanguage.com. All right, everybody, keep learning. Cheers.